France are reacting to these attacks.
Yeah, Yasser Lawati joins us from Paris. He's a spokesperson of the Collective Against Islamophobia in France. Yasser, thank you so much for joining us. What is the feeling right now in the Muslim community after these events of Friday evening?
Right now, the reaction is we are seeing lockdown with those French people. We still don't know who these people were. We barely know what they wanted. But right now, for the Muslim community, we are, you know, some of us lost some relatives. And we keep receiving news now, right now, of hate speech being spread throughout, you know, social media. But regardless of that, we are still receiving a huge amount of solidarity from our fellow countrymen. So the Muslim community still belongs to this country and will do so for a very long time. The problem is that we are still mixing the Muslim community and giving them somehow an affiliation with these terrorists. But we are paying two prices. The price of being targeted by these terrorists and some of the right-wing columnists, like one of your guests just said, like, you know, we are being asked to choose our camp. Our camp is a French one. Make no mistake about it.
Well, Yasser, if your camp is the French camp, why is it that no one within the Muslim community there in France knew what these guys were up to? Because it seems to me that this was a pretty big plan. Surely someone beyond the seven guys who have been killed over the last 48 hours would have to have known something, and that was probably within the Muslim community, but yet no one said anything.
Sir, the Muslim community has nothing to do with these guys. Nothing. We cannot justify ourselves for the actions of someone who just claims to be Muslim. Our you know, secret services knew about these guys, and again, just like during the January attacks, it turned out they were all, you know, on a blacklist somewhere, somehow, on a desk. So right now, we can't take responsibility for anything. Right now, what these terrorists are claiming
what is the responsibility because of the Muslim?
The French nation and the
Sure. Sorry to interrupt, Yasser, but what is the responsibility within the Muslim community to identify what is happening within their own ranks when it comes to people who are obviously training and preparing to carry out mass murder?
No, sir. They were not from our ranks. If they were trained, they were trained abroad. And what these terrorists are blaming our country for is for its failed foreign policy. But of course, they will use people who are falling in the trap of social insecurity and, of course, being cast aside from the rest of French society. So we cannot accept the idea that these people are from us. They are not. They are just the byproduct of our societies, exporting their wars abroad and expecting no repercussion back home.
But Yasser, let's talk about the bigger issue, the fact that France does have a large number of Muslims that have gone over to join ISIS and be part of their ranks. Why is that? You may say that there's no responsibility for these attacks that took place on Friday, but there is that outstanding issue that we must come to terms with. Help us understand that.
Okay, France is home to the biggest Muslim minority in Europe. At the same time, it has the greatest number of laws specifically targeting the Muslim community. And at the same time, France has exported more, you know, foreign terrorist fighters than any other European country. So there is indeed an issue, but that issue is related to foreign policies and failed domestic policies. When it comes to the Muslim community itself, everybody knows that radicalization does not take place in mosques. It takes place either on the internet or on the streets, away from organized communities. That's something we need to keep repeating. So that's why the Muslim community, when they say we cannot be held responsible of these people, that's the government's job. When you have criminals running around in the country, you do your job and arrest them. And somehow, again, everybody came to agree that those people were unknown by the police and the secret services. What were they doing in the meantime? And at the same time, yes. To add one more thing, those terrorists targeted everybody.
Given the fact that the finger of blame is pointed at the Muslim community, rightly or wrongly, does that not shift you into a situation where the Muslim community and the leaders should step up and take a greater role in looking at the young people and the road that they're going down? You have to accept that responsibility to prevent the bigger backlash that comes your way when these things happen.
Okay, all right. So let's speak about our leaders. We have a whole generation of people who are trained in Islamic, you know, Islamic education, and they are put aside and replaced by imams coming from abroad who know nothing about what's going on in France. Absolutely nothing. So when these youth come to them with their questions about existence and their role in society, they don't have any answer. What they do, they go on the internet to seek answers with very simplistic narratives. At the same time, the Muslim community keeps asking the government, stop interfering with our religious affairs. Stop nominating our imams. Stop blocking this from having our own schools. And first and foremost, stop stalling on anti-discriminatory policies. I mean, if the two places for to live together in societies are schools and work. At the same time, in France, and every single report says it, our schools in France and our places of work are places of massive discrimination. What else can we do?
Yeah, so thank you for being with us. This is a very complicated issue, and unfortunately we didn't really have enough time to get into it, but yes, Luwani there, spokesman for the Collective Against Islam.